It was an image which summed up French defiance and a famous victory at England's expense. Mathieu Bastareaud, fists clenched, roaring at his teammates, "Allez, allez, allez, go, go, go." The Toulon centre was regarded as the main threat to Eddie Jones's team in this NatWest Six Nations encounter, and he justified that billing. He gradually took charge of his personal duel with Bentheo and would go on to become the figurehead for what amounted to a stunning upset. When France needed a figure to inspire them, Bastareaud answered the call. The men around him and the home fans in the stadium fed off his energy and sheer, fervent will to win. This Anglo-French clash of No-13s came on a day when Gary Ringrose had excelled in that midfield role for Ireland, in their victory over Scotland. But while the Leinster centre's game is founded on nimble, elusive running, Bastareaud and Theo are very different beasts, with raw power at the heart of their repertoire. They went into this game sharing the same target, to blast holes in the rival defence and offload for the fast men around them. The problem was that they were forced to operate from a limited supply of useful attacking possession. Bastareaud's first significant involvement was to win a breakdown penalty for his side. It wouldn't be his last, as England again struggled in that critical area. They also struggled for ball-carrying impact, as Nathan Hughes was forced off injured in the first half. But in that regard, Theo was the primary English asset. His first carry saw him bust out of an attempted double tackle and make ground, and the next time he got his hands on the ball, the cross-code man burst past Francois Trindouk to give the visitors precious momentum again. Later in the first half, Theo made another dynamic attacking charge on the left to ignite an English attack, and he was certainly trumping Bastareaud at that stage, with his gain-line-busting exploits. The Frenchman was tending to pass before contact, rather than making the aggressive inroads that he did against Italy 15 days earlier. But after the break, the pendulum swung in favor of the home hero. Bastareaud came into his own to dominate the occasion. He set the tone for the French fight back by stopping Theo in his tracks with a shuddering tackle, and that induced a frenzied tribute from the crowd. Moments later, the Gallic giant was at it again, this time smashing Sam Simmons with another statement intervention in defense. The force was with him and Bastareaud was in his element. It wasn't long before he managed to curtail an England raid in his team's 22 by clamping over the ball at a ruck and refusing to shift. It was always felt that if France were to have a chance of winning this game, Bastareaud would have to be the talisman who inspired them. That scenario was coming to pass, but Theo wouldn't just accept that the game was up. When England finally claimed a try, he was the one who set the wheels in motion by storming clear in midfield. His pass out left to Elliot Daly was not quite on target, but the momentum he had generated allowed the visitors to strike at last. It wasn't enough though. Bastareaud had the last laugh, and the last roar.